Well, it's happened again, an emergency landing of a military plane in Milwaukee. As WISN 12 News first reported as breaking news last night at 10, this was the third time that's happened in recent weeks. Now, new at 6, WISN 12 News' Kent Wainscott joins us live. And Kent, the incident raises new questions about the age of that fleet.
Yeah, Craig, the emergency landing actually happened right behind me here, and the plane involved, a refueling tanker, was built in 1958. Now, the 128th has a fleet of those refuelers out here, many of them just beyond that cargo plane you see behind me there. And military officials are, again, answering questions about the age of those aircraft, although the folks who fly them are confident they're safe. Maintenance mechanics delved through the engine of the KC-135 searching for the cause of a fuel flow warning that forced the crew to shut down one of the engines shortly after takeoff Tuesday evening.
And after the engine was shut down, they declared an in-flight emergency and then returned back here to Milwaukee.
The plane landed safely, but it was an experience that's becoming all too common here. This is at least the third incident we've seen in recent weeks, though, involving one of these aircraft.
We have had a number of in-flight emergencies in just recent times, and it honestly is coincidence.
This was the scene earlier this month when another KC-135 reported an engine failure and was forced to make an emergency landing here. Another emergency landing happened in late April because of a windshield issue on one of the planes, and now this third case, again an engine safety issue on one of the refueling tankers.
We're inside now at the controls of that aircraft that experienced the in-flight emergency. This is the gauge that showed the crew that they were experiencing a fuel flow problem to that engine.
The crew trains for problems like that and was well prepared, but it raises questions about the age of these refueling planes.
Is this something that needs to be replaced?
At some point in time, any piece of equipment will need to be replaced. This plane in particular was built in 1958.
The Air Force has been considering replacements for the KC-135s for about a decade, but it will be another 15 years or more before a new fleet is in place. Meanwhile, these half-century-old planes continue to be upgraded with new equipment and put to use.
And once the diagnostic is done and the repairs are made, it'll be back in the air.
Back in the air, that's right.
Now, every one of the 128th's KC-135 aircraft is at least 50 years old, and now WISN 12 News has obtained this Defense Department plan just released within the past week. It outlines a plan to replace those old aircraft with new planes that will begin to be used in the year 2028. But they'll be stationed at bases in other states, not here in Milwaukee. The 128th, meanwhile, could still be flying those same KC-135s for decades to come. Reporting live from the 128th Air Refueling Wing in Milwaukee, I'm Kent Wainscott, WISN 12 News.
Thanks, Kent.